The crisis we're living through will change the elites, both on the political side and on the business side.
New protectionist measures were introduced, even after the G20 leaders' commitments against doing so last November.
India needs to focus on tapping the fortune at the bottom of the pyramid.
Energy is not a neutral, it's not a fungible, it's not even a commercial concept, it is a political tool.
I'm saying to both sides, developed and developing countries, to make compromise, to be engaged in the real negotiation. That is my message.
Organized crime is bad for the world because it thrives on and encourages weak states and political instability.
Khodorkovsky thought that, no, this is not my game. Very thorough search on his tax evasion schemes, which he, like everybody else in Russia, used, was successful, and the fate of Khodorkovsky, you know. And from that moment on, the trust to the equal dialogue with tycoons was over.
If the country chooses to be a democratic country, it has with the democracy, it takes some issues also. Democracy means consensus building.
Let me underline my fundamental conviction that Europe must not contemplate on exit strategy when it comes to the Western Balkans.
Let's break down the barriers. Let's take these countries in. It is in our interest to have all of the Balkans operating on the same legal system as we do. Whether we have -4, 0.2, or 7% growth, the EU will fail if it fails to stick to its principles and its laws.
Each time Russia was promised that NATO infrastructure will not be advanced further than Berlin, each time we are, of course, disappointed when, nevertheless, infrastructure advances. But is our reaction wise, or should we do it in some other way? I do not have an easy and ready answer to this.
Poverty is a driver of organized crime, the central driver of organized crime. Demand in the West is a driver of organized crime. And thanks to the Madoff and Stanford cases, we now know that lax regulatory regimes in Wall Street, London, and elsewhere enabled huge criminal acts to be perpetrated in the very heart of the machine.
Serbia has been capturing and sending in the Hague Tribunal 44 persons, including two presidents of Serbia, former president of Serbia. European countries have some concerns about our goodwill to do that. But I have concerns that this issue is connected with enlargement fatigue.
Some talk about Doha fatigue, but this is no time for being tired.
We are preparing reforms in our country, not because of trying to become more formally member state of European Union, but because of development in our country and real benefits which we can achieve alone.
I would say that expert community and its discussion, which at the moment looks very academic and short-circuit, nevertheless is number one to change the country if we can change it.